So I'm here with Chris Blyth, and we're going to talk about flu vaccine and coronavirus. Chris, this year we've heard talk about flu vaccine being more important than ever. Is that the case, and why?
Yes, it is important this year. In fact, it's critically important to consider an influenza vaccine this year. And that's not because an influenza vaccine has any activity against the coronavirus. It's just an influenza vaccine will keep people healthy, will keep their lungs healthy as they transit through this difficult winter time at a time when coronavirus is spreading. We know that respiratory viruses and other respiratory infections often clump together, and we want to keep people as healthy throughout this period of time. So I'd encourage all people who are considering an influenza vaccine to talk to their healthcare provider about accessing one this year. It's a good reminder to tell people that young children, particularly those under the age of 5, are now funded to receive an influenza vaccine, as are the elderly, as are pregnant women, and those with chronic medical conditions. But those who are not in those groups can still access an influenza vaccine through their healthcare provider, and for many through their pharmacy.
So you'd recommend that all of us get a flu vaccine?
I would recommend that all of us get an influenza vaccine, particularly this year. Anyone over the age of 6 months. Unfortunately, children under the age of 6 months are not eligible, but vaccinating their mums during pregnancy is the most important protection those children can get as well.
And when is the vaccine going to be available?
Vaccines normally become available in April, and I expect vaccines to be available in April this year. Sometimes they're available in pharmacies for a couple of days before that, but importantly, they'll be distributed in April, May, June. But importantly, you can get an influenza vaccine at any time from April onwards. So even towards the end of the influenza season, if you have not been vaccinated, you can still access a vaccine, and I encourage people to do that.
In previous years, we've been advised to hold off getting your flu vaccine too early, mm-hmm. so that you were vaccinating during the peak of the flu season. Mm-hmm. What's the recommendation this year?
So influenza in Western Australia normally peaks in July and August. So previously, we've told people to delay a little bit. With coronavirus being around, I'm encouraging people, when a vaccine is available, to reach to it then.
Okay. So from April onwards. Soon as possible. Yep. All right. Is there going to be enough vaccine? I imagine it's going to be pretty popular.
There is. Certainly my understanding of the ordering is we catered for enough vaccine. And importantly, I would be speaking to your healthcare provider about the best way to access one.
And if you get it as soon as it comes out in April, and we find out that the flu season actually doesn't come until August, September, is that too late to provide protection, and should you be getting a second dose at that point?
No, it's not too late. We know for the vast majority of influenza vaccines, the duration of protection is over that season. There are specific situations where you may consider a second vaccine, and that's only if you're travelling to the Northern Hemisphere in the latter part of the year, or sometimes in pregnant women who've had a previous vaccination last year but are now pregnant. For most people, we're recommending one influenza vaccine per year. The only group who don't get that is those who are having influenza vaccine for the first time and are young children. They get two.
Okay, that's great. Well, so this is the year you definitely want to get your flu shot and get it early. That's it for now. We'll come back with some more information next time.